Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار قال الله تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد Respected brothers and sisters in Iman, elders, young children, sisters, mothers, grandmothers, whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed, whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought in his house, I advise you, starting by myself, that always we should fear Allah. Fear Allah in your tongue, fear Allah in your thoughts, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all intentions that you are making. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil jawarih, the limbs of your body, your hand, your leg, private parts, stomach, what goes in, your ears, your eyes, Na'am, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, haqqa taqwa, fear Allah as he ought to be feared. The unwan of my khutbah is a continuation which I disconnected a few weeks ago because of after election and other important issues that I intended to address. And today, inshallah, al-rihla ila al-akhira continues. Our journey to akhira. Inshallah, today, we will stop at a station known as Ardul A'mal. Ardul A'mal lil Hisab. We have left Hawd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And remember the end of hadith. Whoever drinks, man shariba minha. Whosoever drinks from that Hawd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lam yadma abada. Never will he be thirsty again. You haven't even entered Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has quenched your thirst permanently, not temporarily. فَلِذَلِكَ we are pushed to Ardul A'mal. This is a station where we will be presented to Allah. Our A'mal will be presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will be exhibited. It is a show of A'mal and our life in this world. والدليل قوله تعالى, the proof that there is art is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في القرآن, يَوْمَئِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِرٍ. On that day, all of you, الْأَوَّلُونَ وَالْآخِرُونَ, إِنْسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ, we will be presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will be exhibited. Our a'mal will be presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, on that day you shall be presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La takhfa minkum khafiya. Nothing will hide from you. It is a day which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yawma tubla sarair. Yawma tubla sarair. It is a day when all secrets will be brought forth. They will be brought in open. Na'am, nothing is gonna hide. Anything that you did in secret and you did not make tawbah. Any mazalim that you took, you crooked your brother, you stole from him and you never returned. You abused somebody's honor and dignity. You backbited somebody, you lied, you set up your brother. On that day, all secrets will be brought open. فَلِذَلِكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَ. Nothing is gonna hide. Nothing will be concealed. Nobody is gonna say, oh, but this is not gonna come out. لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَ. Respected brothers in Islam, أحباب رسول الله, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates hadith, which is collected by Ibn Majah, At-Tirmidhi, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahumullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on them for their effort, their sacrifices, their commitment in this deen, that whenever a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are mentioned, their name comes first. They worked very hard to collect this ahadith. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu says, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, that the messenger of Allah, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, say, يعرض الناس يوم القيامة ثلاث عرضات. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will present, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will exhibit, not to be bought. We will be brought in our a'mal in an open in three categories. فأما عرضتان, as for the two first categories, فجدال ومعاذير. فجدال ومعاذير. فجدال ومعاذير. نعم, people will come, يوم تأتي كل نفس تجادل عن نفسها. People will start arguing against themselves. People will argue against others. Some people will try to put their mistakes and their crimes on others. Fajidal, people will be debating against themselves, with their families, with their mothers. Think a father, a mother, think that your son is going to have a debate with you in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walidi, father, you made me a doctor, but you never taught me Surah Al-Fatiha. Tell Allah that you never did that. Oh, mom, you gave me all love, but you never connected me to Allah. Oh, parents, it was a blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought me in dunya through you, but you never guided me to Allah. Your dream was dunya and not akhirah. Now I find myself here. Can you talk to Allah, oh my parents? Can you speak the truth, oh my parents? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْحَقِّ. That is a truthful day. That day will occur and people will only speak the truth. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَأَمَّا أَوْ فَأَمَّا عَرْضَتَانِ. As for the first two categories, فَجِدَالٌ, is a debate. Debate that you never witness in your life. Normally we defend ourselves. Normally the rest of the community is bad, not you. Normally it's your wife who is bad, not you. Normally all your relatives are bad. Normally your colleagues are bad, not you. That day, يَوْمَ تَأْتِي كُلُّ نَفْسٍ تُجَادِلُ عَنْ نَفْسِهَا. You gonna debate against yourself. طيب, ومعذير. What is ma'adhir? People will bring a lot of excuses. Excuses. فَجِدَالٌ وَمَعَذِيرٌ. A lot of excuses. I wish if I did this. I wish if I did that. I wish if I did this, I would have been righteous. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. That is a regret. When a zalim, an oppressor, unjust, a wrongdoer who loved doing wrong deeds, when he will bite his finger and he will say in regret, يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. Woe unto me. I regret today. I wish if I chose the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as my path. Today you are playing, it may be okay. Today you follow hawa nafs. Ah, whatever your hawa tells you, even if it contradicts the deen, even if it contradicts Allah, if it contradicts Rasulullah, you are okay with it. That day you're gonna regret. Jidalun wa ma'adhir. This person will not stop there. لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. Woe unto me. I wish I didn't take so and so as my friend. Wallahi, your best friend today is going to run away from you and maybe he's going to blame you on the day of there. You are talking yourself. Nobody's helping you to talk here. يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي. This person misled me after the reminder and remembrance of Allah has come to you. Quran came to you. Sunnah of Rasulullah came to you. Islam reached to you. You never chose, we never appreciated your deen. You never ever made extra effort to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You thought that you are more smarter because you know some sciences and some physics here and there, and you are good in biology, so you are smarter than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wal-iyadu billah. لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. Shaitan to human being is a betrayer. He doesn't want any good for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remind you when you are saying these words, trying to blame the situation. I wish. أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Didn't I take your covenant, O sons of Adam, that you should not worship Shaitan? إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Didn't I inform you that Shaitan is a manifest and a clear and open enemy to you? وَأَنِ اعْبُدُونِي هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ. Didn't I tell you that the only one who has right to be worshipped is me? Worship me. This is the صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ. وَلَقَدْ أَضَلَّ مِنْكُمْ جِبِلًّا كَثِيرًا أَفَلَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعَقِلُونَ. I told you that Shaitan has led many, many generations. Didn't you use your brain? Didn't you think and reflect?
هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون. Since you chose the path of Shaitan and not the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the jahannam that you've been promised. Fajidalun wa ma'adhi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Oh, my slaves, tell my slaves who have excessively wronged themselves, I killed, I did that, all jara'ib, all crimes, all sins that you have committed, come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. It is now, not tomorrow. Because we do not know if tomorrow is going to come. إذا كنت بالأمس اقترفت إساءة فبادر بإحسان وأنت حميد فلعل غد يأتي وأنت فقيد. Tomorrow may come when you are gone. Tomorrow may come when you are performing salatul janaza in the masjid. Tomorrow may come when you have disappeared with aeroplane. Even your qabr is not known. فَبَادِرْ بِإِحْسَانٍ وَأَنْتَ حَمِيدٌ فَلَعَلَّ غَدِي يَأْتٍ وَأَنْتَ فَقِيدٌ. Repent now. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not give up. Do not lose hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all sins. Innahu huwa al-ghafurur rahim. Now Allah says, wa anibu ila rabbikum. Make a decision now and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. Al-inaba. Min qabli an ya'tiyakum al-'adhabu thumma la tusarun. Before the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to you and you find that there is no one to save you from the punishment of Allah. Wattabi'u ahsana ma unzila ilaykum min rabbikum. This is the time that you are advised. You are listening to me and this is hujja alayk. You are listening to me. Wattabi'u ahsana ma unzila ilaykum min rabbikum. And follow the best ahsana, the best which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent from him. فَإِنَّ أَحْسَنَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. Any part of knowledge does not surpass Al-Qur'an, does not surpass Kitabu Allah. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُم مِّن قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ بَغْتَةً وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. Before the punishment of Allah, before the wrath of Allah, before the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fall upon you, suddenly, when you perceive not, أن تقول نفس, lest this soul say on the day of Qiyamah, يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله. Woe unto me, I am a loser, I transgress the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمنا. Subhanallah, my brothers, why should you regret on the day of Qiyamah when you have been reminded in Quran? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, each one of us knows at least one hadith, thousands of hadith. Each one of us knows that inna deena inda Allah islam. Each one of us knows that you cannot succeed fi dunya wal akhirah except if you follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qul in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum wallahu ghafurur rahim. Why do you invest? Why is your investment with Allah is blames and complaints and lying on the day of Qiyamah, ma'adhir, arguments, excuses? Why? Why do you build a house of jidal wa ma'adhir? Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will succeed. Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ma atakumur rasulu fakhuduhu wa ma nahakum anhu fantahu. Whatsoever Rasul gave you, receive it, apply it in your life. And whatever Rasul forbade, avoid it, shun it. لأن الرسول لم يكن ينطق عن الهوى. He wasn't just talking out of his own desire. إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. All that he brought to us of deen is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another one saying, أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين. This is a liar. This is the lie on the day of Qiyam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an'amahu bil Islam, wa an'amahu bil Qur'an, wa an'amahu bi Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What guidance do you still want that had Allah guided me, I would have been among the pious? It was your choice not to be among al-muttaqun. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أنني كرة فأكون من المحسنين. All these are lying, ولا ينفعك الندم. It will be too late to regret on that day. Hadith of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه. He said, وأما عرض الثالثة. As for the third part of presentation, the third category of presentation, فعند ذلك تطير الصحف في الأيدي فآخذ بيمينه وآخذ بشماله. This is when the books of records will fly. They will fly. Now these books will fly towards the hands. It depends. They will be released, يعني. They will be released. فآخذ بيمينه وآخذ بشماله. Some people will receive their books in the right hand, and some will receive their books in the left hand. My respected brothers, Aisha radiallahu anha says, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, من نوقش الحساب عذبه. That anyone who will be engaged to detail his a'mal, anyone who will be interrogated on the day of Qiyamah regarding his life in this world, he will be punished. Aisha radiallahu anha qalat kultu. She said, I said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alaysa yaqulu Allah ta'ala, doesn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in Quran, fasawfa yuhasabu hisaba yasira? Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise that he will recall us easily and smoothly? Our recalling will be smooth. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ذلك العرض. What is meant in the ayah is when al-mu'min is presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But anyone who will be interrogated, anyone who will be interrogated in details in this place, he will have to go through some punishment. Al-hisab haqqun. Reckoning is true. That is why Qiyamah is also called yawmul hisab. It is a day of reckoning. Anything that you did will come to an open. Any injustice towards your wife will come to an open. Any injustice towards your husband will come to an open. Young people, you call your parents old school. Sometimes you insult them that they are mean. You insult them sometimes. I don't expect parents to be rude to their sons. You need to have rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them in this life through you. But children, you have to obey your parents. You have to obey your mom and your dad. You have to love them. Any injustice that you do against them will be brought in open on the day of Qiyamah. يَوْمَ تُبْلَى السَّرَائِرِ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَلَا نَاصِرٍ. No one is going to claim that I have power to exit from this. No one is going to say that I have a way of helping you or saving you from this. فَجِدَالٌ وَمَعَذِيرٌ. ثم ماذا عند ذلك تطير الصحف في الأيدي فآخذ بيمينه وآخذ بشماله. Think about that day. You are with your family. You are with your wife. You are with your children that you love. Then you find yourself blaming yourself. You find your wife blaming you. You find your children blaming you. Brothers who are owning businesses, don't oppress your employees. Don't ever use your position as an owner of business to oppress you are. Some of us are paying our employees $5 here simply because it is called under table, right? Allah will ask you about the oppression. Don't ever use your knowledge to oppress people. Don't ever use your wealth to oppress people. Don't ever use your business and position to oppress people. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ إِنَّكَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Do not use a small position Allah has given you to oppress others. All these will come in open Yawma Tubla Sarai. Tayyib, my brothers, there is a relief on the day of Qiyamah in this station for Al-Mu'minun. And we want to examine quickly what is going to be the hala of Munafiqun wal Kuffar. Guiding us is hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma. When one person met him on the road and asked him, ماذا سمعت عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم? What did you hear from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم regarding النجوى, secret conversation on the day of Qiyamah? فقال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, I heard the Prophet of Allah, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُدْنِي الْمُؤْمِنِ. On the day of Qiyamah, in this station, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring closer a mu'min. You need to ask yourself, am I a Muslim or am I a mu'min? Sometimes Iman and Islam comes together, and many times they separate. قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم. نعم, some Bedouin Arabs claim that we have true believers. They reverted to Islam. After a few days, kida, they came to Rasul and say, we are a community. We are true believers. Because we believe without being forced in Islam. We didn't need to fight and all this. So we are true believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam with the following message, and this is part of Surah Al-Hujurat 49. قالت الأعراب آمنا. Bedouin Arabs claims that we have believed, we have true faith. قل لم تؤمنوا. Tell them that you have not yet believed. You do not need to claim Iman now. ولكن قولوا أسلمنا. What you should claim now is that we are Muslims. ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم. Because Iman has not yet entered into your hearts. Islam is a ni'mah from Allah. Iman is a responsibility. You have to bring Iman into your hearts to deserve to be called Al-Mu'min. فيوم القيامة إن الله عز وجل يدني المؤمن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring closer to him Al-Mu'min. فيضع عليه كنفة فيستره من الناس. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover him, will conceal him from people. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his mercy, out of his bounties, out of his love on you, he is bringing you closer, covering you that nobody is listening to your secret talk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيَسْتُرُهُ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Allah wanna talk to you, he is covering you. مَا أَحْلَمَ اللَّهُ عَنَّا حَيْثُ أَمْهَلَنَا وَقَدْ تَمَادَيْنَا فِي الذُّنُوبِ وَيَسْتُرُنَا أَنَا الَّذِي أَغْلِقُ الْأَبْوَابَ مُجْتَهِدًا عَلَى الْمَعَاسِ وَعَيْنُ اللَّهِ تَنْظُرُ. How merciful is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us. We have transgressed the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with bil ma'asiyah. We do not perform salah, we don't care, we don't pay zakah, we say it's my money. Al-malu malullah. يقول الإنسان مالي مالي وما للأموال أتركها خلفي وأخرج من دنياي عريانا. How much are you going to put in your pocket when you die? I have buried many people. Maybe today is me. Wallahi, maybe this masa is me. Wallahi, maybe tomorrow is me. Lakin, how much are you going to take with you to the qabr? What is wrong with us? How comes that we don't reflect? وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس وما يعقلها إلا العالمون. We have Quran, but you find that human being, وكان الإنسان أكثر شيء جدلا. If you want to see somebody who is quarrelsome, somebody who has argued with Allah than any other creation, is a human being. Now these five prayers, why Allah didn't make them too? I'm tired, why should I worship Allah? Zakah, why can't Allah say anything you want to give, even 5 cents? Ramadan, why can't we fast only for one day? Hajj, why should I spend my money to travel? Who is going to take care? Always, we argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is all merciful. Allah is so merciful. He gives us chance after chance. We disobey Allah, yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting us to make tawbah. And he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. طيب أحباب, that hadith. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings you closer, and he has concealed you, he has protected you, that nobody is going to listen to your conversation. فَيُقَرِّرُهُ بِذُنُوبِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remind you and will make you to confess about all your sins. A private conversation بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ الْضَعِيفِ بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ حَقِيرِ بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ. This human being with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's still giving you that chance. You go to this court, you cannot come closer to judge. You cannot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is honoring you again. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fayaqulu lahu, Allah will tell him, do you know, a'arafta dhanba kada? Hal a'arafta dhanba kada? Hal a'arafta dhanba? In this hadith, 3 times. Do you remember such and such sin that you committed? Do you remember such and such crime that you committed? Do you remember such and such? Hatta idha aqarrahu bidhunubi. Until when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded him and he or she has confessed that I did this, O Allah, no one among the creation of Allah is, not even malaika, are listening to this conversation. And so you have some atheists, when they are sick, make dua for me. Why do you need dua if you are an atheist? When they die, please make dua. Da Allah lahi. Why do you make dua if you are an atheist? You choose not to believe in Allah. You are arguing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. You choose the path of denying and rejecting Allah. فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ مِمَّا خُلِقَ خُلِقَ مِمَّا إِنْ دَافِقَ يَخْرُجُ مِنْ بَيْنِ الصُّلْبِ وَالتَّرَائِقِ خُلِقَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ حَقِيرٍ. Look at yourself before you open your mouth to argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Aziz. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qawi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Wahhab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Qahhab. Dhul Jalali wal Ikram. Walillahi asma'ul husna fad'uhu biha. Go and play with other creation. Don't. You cannot afford to deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is wrong with us? Tayyib, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded you about all this and you have confessed. Hatta idha aqarrahu Allah, idha aqarrahu bidhunubi wa ra'a fi nafsihi annahu qad halak, until he feel that I am destroyed. I did all this. Allah has reminded me. I have been exposed by Allah. Wallahi, I did all this. I will be destroyed. I am doomed. I will go to Jahannam. Yani his nafs is telling him that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him the following. Qala Allah, Allah will tell this person who has confessed of all his sins and crimes, that satartuha inni satartuha alayka fi dunya. I have a good news for you. That when you did all these sins, I covered them for you. I didn't want to let anybody know whatever wrong you did. Satartuha alayka fi dunya. Wa ana aghfiruha laka al-yawm. And I want to tell you, with all those sins that you committed, I will forgive all of them to you today. Wa man yaghfiru dhunuba illa Allah. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون. Who else forgives sins except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How many times do we make istighfar since morning? Forget about that rushing istighfar after salam. Forget about that. How many times do you spare time to say, I want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my sins? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa huwa khayru al-anam, wa huwa khayru al-khalaiq, wa huwa khayru al-baraya, kana yastaghfirullah mi'ata marra fil yawm. He doesn't have sin, yet he dedicates his time to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. How many times do you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness? Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, coming to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa huwa khayru hadhihi al-ummah ba'da Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr knows that I'm going to Jannah. Do you know whether you are going to Jannah or not? Imam Shafi doesn't know. You. And he's asking Rasulullah, ya Rasulullah, allimni du'a'an, allimni du'a'an ad'uka bihi fi salati wa fi bayti. Teach me a du'a, ya Rasulullah. Teach me a dua, ad'u biha This dua, when I'm performing salah, I will include it, I will recite it. And also when I'm at home, I will recite it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, say, Allahumma gfir li dhunubi. Oh Allah, forgive me my sins. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتِ. For no one forgives sins except you, O Allah. فَغْفِرْ لِي مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِكَ وَرْحَمْنِي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O Allah, forgive me with forgiveness from you. And have mercy on me, O Allah. You are the only of forgiving and most merciful. كَمْ نَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ كَمْ نَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ فِي الْيَوْمِ. How many times do we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness? فَلِذَلِكَ this person, Allah tells him, I concealed, I covered it for you. You did it. You didn't do it right. But I have covered it for you. And today I have forgiven you. فَيُعْطَى كِتَابَ حَسَنَاتِ. Then he will be given the book of his what? Good deeds. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already concealed for him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has protected him. أَحْبَابَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Time is behind us. In front of us, and we have to try our best to prepare our history, our book, our legacy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Soon or later, you will die. Death doesn't know a professor, death doesn't know a rich man, death doesn't know Imam or Sheikh, death doesn't know a Nabi, min al anbiya aw al rasul, death does not know a child or a grown up. فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ لَا يَسْتَخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. Prepare for that day. يَوْمُ الْعَرْضِ عَرْضُ الْأَعْمَالِ يَوْمُ الْعَرْضِ لِلْحِسَابِ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reckon us. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to be better Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promote us to iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promote our a'mal to taqwa. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. إِسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد وبارك وسلم. أحباب رسول الله, أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله. اتقوا الله فقد فاز المتقون. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم ارض عن جميع صحابة رسول الله. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والكفرة والمبتدعة والمشركين. اللهم انصر من نصر دينك واخذل من خذل المسلمين. واجعل اللهم بلدتنا هذه آمنة مطمئنة وعلى سائر البلدان المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى جميع المسلمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى جميع المسلمين. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا, يسر لنا ولا تعسر, وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين. اللهم لا سهلا إلا ما جعلته سهلا, وسهل لنا لما نريد, نجنا مما نخاف, بفضلك يا لطيف, برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصرنا على أعدائنا. والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة.